With the battle line of the chip war already drawn, ASML has now been put in a difficult position. It's either the firm rides with the chip sanctions placed against China or they are against it. However, what if we told you they've chosen the latter? With the significant external pressures from America, the age-old saying, "Desperate situations require desperate measures," has taken center stage. In today's video, we will reveal more about ASML's current stance in the chip war, its dramatic actions, and the underlying reason why they appear to be against the chip ban. The chip war as we know it all started when the United States of America, along with other members of the Chip 4 alliance which comprises South Korea, Japan, Taiwan, and of course, the United States of America, began to cut ties with China to an extent, especially within the supply chain of semiconductors. Then again, given how the alliance was reportedly proposed as part of America's plans to reduce the global reliance on China-made chips, it's difficult to say the severing of ties came as a surprise. Despite all of that though, there was still a crucial piece missing in the grand puzzle that none of the Asian semiconductor powerhouses could fill. Have you already figured out who we're referring to? In case you haven't, we're talking about none other than the Netherlands. Getting the Dutch into the field of play was crucial. Along with Japan, the Netherlands is home to crucial players in semiconductor manufacturing equipment. This small European nation is home to ASML Holding NV, a company unlike any other. Saying ASML is one of the most important companies across the globe, as far as manufacturing chips is concerned, is a massive understatement. They control the entire global market for lithography technology. In case you didn't know, nobody else in the world makes super complex extreme ultraviolet UV lithography machines. On Earth, this is the ultimate machine needed to develop cutting-edge semiconductors. Without UVs, your chips are going to be severely behind the times. And the sad part of it all is that every chip maker knows this. Giant chip-making firms like Samsung, Intel, and TSMC fully depend on ASML Holding to provide the all-important UV lithography machines. Some experts even believe America's plan to cripple China's access to cutting-edge chip manufacturing equipment wouldn't have been successful without the support of the Dutch. According to them, it simply wouldn't have had that much effect. Perhaps that's why the Biden administration started persuading the Netherlands as well as other allies to join America's campaign barely a few weeks after announcing it. Can you see why America needed the Netherlands to side with them? Unlike the other nations in the alliance, a simple export restriction was all that the Biden administration needed to keep China in a state of panic. For a long time now, America has been particularly wary of ASML shipping its advanced chip-making technology to China. According to popular belief, Chinese chipmakers had what it takes to harness advanced semiconductors, possibly the most advanced in the world, and use them for artificial intelligence applications as well as other military purposes. From the American viewpoint, the latter scares them the most. China is probably the biggest threat to national security, or at least they made it seem that way. The regulations regarding chip exports aren't new. Since 2018, America has been placing pressure on Dutch lawmakers to ensure ASML puts an end to the exportation of UVs to China. With that in mind, the company's hands were tied. After all, going against the government would be a fool's errand. There's more to the tale though. Just as if that wasn't enough, the American government issued newer rules and restrictions on the supply of chip-making equipment to Chinese customers. In light of the frenzy surrounding the new rules, ASML made a statement. It will take time for these controls to be translated into legislation and take effect. With that being said, how would you choose to interpret the statement of the company? One may say it marks the first crack in the relationship between ASML and America, or perhaps even a sign of resistance. However, on the other hand, it could also mean the company was trying to create a buffer for itself. They'd have to adhere to the new rules, but, thanks to the time they've given themselves, they could increase the costs of shipping their machines to China and thus gain significant profits, especially when you consider China would have to move fast. Speaking of statements, the company also disclosed that the new measures aren't expected to significantly affect its financial books, adding that the additional export controls do not pertain to all immersion lithography tools but only to what is called most advanced. But that turned out to be a problem. The term most advanced is a broad one and thus open to multiple interpretations, not to mention it can be ever-changing. If UVs become redundant, wouldn't it mean they're no longer most advanced and thus part of the equipment permissible to be exported to China? Here's a question for you: what's the next best thing after extreme ultraviolet lithography machines? That's right, Doobs. Since the chip ban started, ASML has been allowed to send off its machine to China. They never knew the newer regulations entailed America's interests to further reduce China's access to advanced chip-making equipment by regulating the exportation of these so-called deep ultraviolet Doobs lithography machines. One thing America has failed to consider, or probably just doesn't care enough about, is that China is a significant client of ASML. Not only is China the largest consumer of semiconductors across the globe, but they are also responsible for 15% of ASML's sales. As a company, ASML simply can't afford to have such an important client chalked off. As much as they're willing to obey the rules, albeit grumbling, they're still a company and surely would like business to be booming as usual. Just as we said earlier, deep ultraviolet lithography machines are not as good as their extreme ultraviolet lithography counterparts. The latter is more state-of-the-art, and the likes of TSMC, Intel, and several others used it to develop chips that utilize the most advanced process nodes in the world. The former may be the best thing after it, but, in terms of comparing the pair, you've simply blow it away. However, don't take that to mean it's not crucial. Doobs are crucial for making chips based on 28-nanometer or larger nodes that have been in severely short supply for quite a while. It's also worth mentioning that this crippling supply has halted the production of everything from phones to cars and even ASML's chip-making gear. Should ASML stop sending Doobs to China, the effects would be crazy. China is already barred from getting its hands on Doobs lithography machines. Adding Doobs to the list would be crushing to China's goals in the field of semiconductors. However, did you know they wouldn't be the only ones to be affected? Just as China would be taking a significant hit, the world as a whole would also be affected. The world is already facing a significant chip deficit and disruption in the supply chain, which has ironically raised the prices for electronics. That's probably why the CEO of ASML, Peter Wennink, warned the lawmakers. We cannot ignore the fact that China has manufacturing capacity out there on Doobs, which the world needs, he states. Back to the business perspective, it's safe to assume ASML isn't keen on letting America have its way, or at least so easily. Should the Netherlands agree to America's demands, you'd be hard-pressed to say it wouldn't significantly affect the firm. Just as we said earlier, China accounts for about 15% of its annual sales, translating to billions in dollars. Acting as an accelerant to the flames of resistance, Peter Wennink has been vocal about his thoughts surrounding the U.S.-led export control measures against China. In an interview with Bloomberg News at ASML's headquarters in Veldhoven, Netherlands, Wennink stated his belief that the measures are essentially meaningless. According to him, in the long run, the measures would only force Beijing to work round the clock to successfully develop its advanced technology and chip making and thus gain self-sufficiency. If they cannot get those machines, they will develop them themselves. That will take time, but ultimately they will get there. He also believes the situation should be addressed by the respective governments involved, to put an end to the long-drawn dispute. It's not just between the Dutch and Americans, it involves other European countries, it involves Asian countries, so it's a complex situation. It is up to governments. I just have to follow what comes out. One thing is clear though. The company wouldn't take no for an answer. Despite the mounting pressure placed on them from the United States of America, ASML has already made it clear they would continue exporting Doobs machines to China at a similar level to last year. This year, the company also expects to earn around $2.3 billion from China alone. However, they're still optimistic that the ongoing talks between the Netherlands, Japan, and the United States of America don't end up with sanctions against China that could jeopardize not only the firm but also the entire semiconductor industry. With everything that has been said and done, what are your thoughts about ASML's stance against America's chip regulations? Do you see a reason for it? Let us know in the comments. See you on the next one.